Okay, willkommen zurück bei Dream Daddy. Ich habe mich gerade fast versprochen, aber das werde ich jetzt nicht rausschneiden, weil... Keine Ahnung, ich mache es einfach nicht. ja, wir sind jetzt in der Schule von Amanda und jetzt gucken wir doch mal, was da so auf uns zukommt. Los geht's! I arrive at Amanda's school and check in at the front desk. They give me a bright orange visitor sticker and send me on my way. In der Schule kriegt man Sticker? Ich kenne das jetzt nur aus... Krankenhäusern? I'm barely awake and feeling pretty haggard, but hopefully nobody will notice. I check my watch and I'm relieved to see that I'm only 2 minutes late. Wait, was it room 103 or 108? I spot a youth standing at his locker and approach him for help. Excuse me, do you know where Mr. Vega's classroom is? The youth turns around and looks me up and down with heavily lined eyes. Cooles Design. Sigh. Come on, kid. I'm late for a meeting. Mr. Who? Mr. Vega. I don't know. Have you tried the exit? Okay, wise guy. Are you gonna help me or not? Sigh. Fine. Up those stairs and to the left. Can't miss him. Ich weiß nicht, warum ich Sigh gesagt habe, anstatt einfach zu machen, aber it is what it is. I head up the stairs and walk around, unable to find Mr. Vega's class anywhere. After a couple minutes of searching, I head back downstairs. That punk you've sent me on a wild goose chase. I get back to where the low-rent Gerard Way is standing, fully ready to give him a piece of my mind, when suddenly a head pops out of the classroom next to his locker.
Oh.
Lucien, don't you have a third period to get to? Fine, Mr. Vega.
Ah.
Wow. Now I'm officially 10 minutes late. I glare at him as he walks away. Super, danke. Danke für nichts, Junge. We are not cool. You must be Lloyd. This period's almost over. Would you mind waiting in the back? Hugo. Mr. Vega leads me in and I take a seat in one of the comically small students' desks in the back. I might get stuck in this. Ist das für die etwas jüngeren Schüler?
Ah.
Alright, where were we? Now, who can tell me about the unreliability of the narrator in J.D. Salinger's Catches in the Rye? Yes, Colin? Colin stands up and does the thing where he blows into the crook of his elbow to make a fart noise. Wow. The whole class erupts in laughter. All right, everybody. Very funny, Colin. Please sit down.
Oh.
Now, Holden Caulfield is an unreliable narrator in the sense that... The bell for the end of the period rings. All of the students immediately get up and make a break for the door. Ja, ich hab schon gedacht, dass das jetzt so dumm kommt. Das wäre jetzt echt viel gewesen.
What?
Remember to do the reading and answer the response questions on page 194 in your textbook. Nobody's listening. Honored, I guess. Mr. Vega turns to me and sighs.
Oh.
Middle schoolers, right. Don't you teach high schoolers? Both, you know, budget cuts. Oh Mann, was für ein Ort ist man denn hier gezogen, dass sie nicht mal die Schulen trennen können? Also, das System ist ja ein bisschen anders in Amerika. Right.
Oh.
Thanks so much for coming in. No problem, Mr. Vega. Please call me Hugo. Warum sind alle gleich so erpicht immer, dass man mit dem Vornamen anfängt? Also, na gut. Weil ist doch eigentlich der Lehrer von meiner Tochter, ne? Also... I don't normally do this impromptu parent-teacher meetings, but as I'm sure you know Amanda's very bright student, I'm concerned about her recent behavior. What's going on? Amanda has never been the most engaged student, but I know she cares. Recently, though, she's been falling behind. She's not completing assignments and has been doing rather poorly on tests. I'd normally chalk this up to senioritis, but this is strange. I thought Amanda always shared everything with me. It hadn't even crossed my mind that something might be wrong. I just wanted to ask, is everything okay at home? We just moved. She's fine. She has a tendency to bottle things up. We just moved. Ich meine, das ist eine legitime, also a legit reason, dass Kinder sich dann anders verhalten, ne? Well, we just moved recently, but it was only to the other side of town, and Amanda was more excited about it than I was.
Oh.
See if you can talk to her about it. I know she values you a great deal and would appreciate your guidance. If she keeps heading down this road... I know how important art school is to her, and I would hate to see her miss out on scholarship money that she clearly deserves. I'll make sure to talk to Amanda. Thanks for letting me know, Hugo. 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 Da kam mein Denglisch ein bisschen raus. Anytime. On my way out, I stop thinking for a moment. I turn to Hugo. Hey, Hugo.
Ah.
Yes? Did I ever catch that rye?
Oh.
Dot, dot, dot. Yes. Oh, cool. Ich musste nicht mal was auswählen. Schön. Haben wir von ihm auch ein paar Herzchen gekriegt. Ich frage mich, ob man irgendwo nachgucken kann, wie der Stand ist bei den verschiedenen Dads. Ich guck das gleich mal. I leave the classroom and make my way out of the school. I'm still a little bit in shock that Amanda was able to hide this so well from me. She's always been such a force for positivity in my life, especially after we lost her father. Amanda must be done with classes for the day by now. I'm sure she will appreciate a ride home, and maybe I can talk to her about what's going on. Okay, let's see what the daughter's up to. Erstmal gucken wir mal hier. Save, lower title. Nein, man hat leider keine Übersicht. Ja, da müssen wir jetzt halt damit leben. Ich meine, vielleicht kommt das auch noch. Ich habe keine Ahnung. Ich bin ja noch nicht lange dabei. I pull up to the carpool and Amanda hops in the passenger seat. So, did you have fun gossiping about me? Mr. Vega and I actually just gossiped about our celebrity crushes. Oh my god. Klar, das sind die Dinge, die man mit Lehrern tut. So you talked about Mario Batali the whole time? It was a very productive meeting. I'm pretty hungry. Can we grab some dinner? Sure thing. We can make something at home. Let's go to the mall food court. Ich wette, das könnte ihr gefallen, also machen wir das. Does that sound good to you?
Hmm.
Yeah, sure. Why the mall? Okay, es gefällt ihr anscheinend dann doch nicht. Aber egal, wir machen das jetzt. Jeez, can't take, oh mein Gott. Can't the dad take his daughter to the mall?
Hmm.
Will you buy me things? I will buy you a thing. Singular. Sounds like a deal to me.
Ah.
We drive in silence for a short while. Amanda plays a game on her phone. I should say something. You know, sometimes when a kid gets older, they find that they have to keep things hidden from their parents. And that's okay, because sometimes that's what kids do. And that's okay, but also sometimes it's good to have the parents' perspective, because, you know, maybe the parents have also dealt with similar situations. And maybe they're a little cooler than you give them credit for. Anyway, what I'm trying to say is that it's good to share. Love you! Have you been reading my tweets? Erstmal Twitter stalken. You have a Twitter? What? Never mind. Look, sweetie, Mr. Vega said you haven't been participating in class and that you're not turning things in. Oh, I'm fine, Pops. Senioritas and all that. I thought you liked Mr. Vega's class.
Ah.
It's fine. He's fine. We pull up to a stoplight and I, Amanda. She's still texting. Just, I want you to know that you can talk to me about anything. Oh, richtiger Dad Talk gerade.
Dad.
Oder generell Parent Talk. Uh-huh. I can tell that whatever it is, she doesn't want me knowing about it. That's frustrating. I heard Emma R's going to that fancy art school in California. That's exciting. Yep. Are you bummed that you guys aren't going to the same school? Yep.
Huh?
Amanda keeps texting. She stifles a laugh. What's so funny? I don't think you'd get it. Okay. Dot, 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 dot. Es sind vier Punkte. are texting.
Ah.
Noah. Who's Noah? My friend. Does he go to your school?
Hmm.
Yep. Do you like Noah?
Ah.
What? No! Dad! Ugh. I can't believe you would...
Ugh.
Dad. I mean, jeez. Why would you? Die Reaktion von ihr, ey. Gold. Gross. Sorry, just asking. Dad, he's just my friend. Guys and girls can be friends. He's my friend. Mm-hmm. Okay. Jeez. This is going well. Very well, I might add. Well, good talk. Love you, kiddo. She leans forward and turns up the radio. I guess the conversation is over. To the mall then. Oh wow, ey, das war ein richtig guter Parent Talk. We arrive at the mall, a big indoor shopping center with a couple of different floors. It's kind of dead, but that doesn't stop a mall security guard from yelling at a group of loitering teens. Let's eat something disgusting for dinner.
Hey.
Hell yeah! Language, Missy.
Huh?
Heck yeah! Better. We approach the food court and evaluate our options. There's a greasy restaurant after greasy restaurant. My heart burns just looking at the menus. Nobody looks happy to be here. What are you in the mood for? Bread dipped in sugar, bread with cheese on it, or do you just want me to inject some fat directly into your bloodstream? Oh, hell yeah. I extend my hand to her. Would you do me the honor of sharing some nachos?
Huh.
She takes my hand with a grin. It would make me the happiest, cheesiest girl alive. Oh man, nachos mit Käse. Cheesiest girl. I get that. We order a giant pile of chips and unnaturally orange cheese from a very Ich hab's heute wieder nicht so mit Aussprache. Unenthusiastic and possibly stoned teenager. We take a seat at a rickety table and dig in.
Whoa.
These are bad. These are very bad. But also strangely delicious.
Mm.
We have to eat through the pain. We enjoy the fluorescent cheesy goodness to get... Ich hab aus Versehen weggedrückt. Entschuldigung. Es gibt auch, glaube ich, keine Rückspulfunktion. Sorry. Einfach kurz zurückspulen und Pause drücken, dann kann man's lesen. So, something's been bothering me for a while. Can you explain memes to me? Oh my god! Memes! Which meme? All memes?
Aww.
Amanda sighs deeply and places her head in her hands. Oh my god, Dad.
Ugh.
Dad, it's complicated. See, memes are inside jokes shared by a bunch of people that get less funny the more people do it. So the problem is that by the time a meme gets to you, Dad, all us youths have already done the joke to death.
Ugh.
And what's worse than that is that movies and TV and video games will try to jump in on a meme train, but just based on how long it takes to make them, the meme will be long dead by the time it comes out. So it just dates it and isn't funny. Oh shit, what up? Dad, please. Anyway, changing the subject. Where to now? Wanna go to that guff store? What? You know, the ones that all black and tries to establish itself as anti-establishment despite being an exact representation of the establishment? I don't know what store you're talking about. You know, the one where you can buy chain wallets, and it's basically an assault on what people fought so hard against in the punk and hardcore movements of the 70s and 80s?
Hmm.
Dude, you gotta be more specific. The one you threw up in that one time. Ich find's so cool, dass das sie einfach Dude nennt.
Ah.
Oh, that one!
Yes!
Yeah! Gehen wir in den Gothic Store. Warum? Also ich meine, okay, mein Dad sieht ein bisschen goth aus, aber warum gerade dahin? Alright. Amanda runs into the store with me trailing behind her. She makes a beeline for the back. There it is! You can still see the outline, kinda. I'm so proud. Speech! Amanda. Speech! Alright, I'll do it if you stop chanting! Yeah, Amanda stops immediately. I clear my throat. Thank you all for joining us here today to commemorate an historic moment that would forever shape history. On a day very much like today, some 5 years ago, our very own Amanda Ann Smith had too much blue raspberry slushy on an outing to the mall. After begging her father to take her to Dead Goth and Beyond to buy rainbow suspenders, she proceeded to throw up all over a display of My Chemical Romance merchandise. Her loving father then had to pay for said merchandise, which to this day remains among our possessions. Thank you. Amanda is moved. She begins clapping, slow at first, then faster and more rigorously. Several other patrons turn their heads, one of them also starts clapping. I bow my head. Thank you. Oh hey, Chain Wallets! Ich muss ja sagen, ich habe früher auch sowas getragen. Also wirklich Kette ans Portemonnaie gebastelt und dann hing das die Hose runter. Es war schon cool. While Amanda busies herself looking at band t-shirts, I try to find something of interest to myself. Not much for a dad to look at in a dad goth and beyond. Peru? Ich glaube, das soll Pursue heißen. The Bench T-Shirts, look at Ironic Max, check the clearance bin for hot deals. Yes! There's a big cardboard box of markdown items. I'm pretty sure $4 for purple eyeliner is a good deal, I think. I'm not sure. I wonder if it would look good in purple eyeliner. Könnt ihr euch meinen Dad mit lila Eyeliner vorstellen? Ich meine, warum nicht? Hell yes, I would. Look, this is very important to me. Oh my god, der Vampire Typ. I overhear a stifled argument over the cash register. An older gentleman is carrying a garment and showing it to a bored looking cashier of pink hair. I can see that. Don't know what to tell you, dude. I just work here.
Oh.
Die klingt so cool. Listen, when I bought this online, the website said this blouse was Victorian inspired. However, when I received it, it clearly held the trademark of Edwardian dressage. Ich hab keine Ahnung, von was ihr redet. Do you want a coupon? I can give you a coupon. Will you leave it if you give a coupon? Ich glaube, das spricht man anders aus im Englischen. Coupon? You get it. Just bear with me. Is there a manager present? People have to know what they're buying. I am the manager.
Huh.
I see. Well, it would seem that I have outstayed my welcome. Good day, shopkeep. Your superiors will receive a strongly worded letter by post. My god, der ist richtig cool. Whatever, dude. The man whirls around and storms out, his literal coattails trailing behind him. I can tell if they are Victorian-inspired or Edwardian in nature. Amanda trots up to me with a t-shirt in her hand. Oh boy, here it comes. Hey, Datron 5000! Yes, I'll buy it for you. Wow, that was easy. Thanks! At least it's only one this time. Amanda plops the shirt onto the counter and grins at the cashier. I love your hair. The cashier says nothing and rings Amanda up, radiating hatred. I hand her a 20. So, what was that guy's deal? The cashier rolls her eyes so hard I'm worried she'll pull something. That's Damien. He's in here all the time. He's obsessed with Victorian fashion or whatever. She hands Amanda her bag and it's clear the conversation is over. We make our way out of the store and head home to get some rest. Ich finde toll, dass mein Dad auch einfach sich denkt so, oh ja, ich frag mal einfach nach so, was es mit diesen anderen Typen auf sich hat. Ich meine, why not?
Okay.
Emma and I sit on the couch trying to find something to watch over bowls of ice cream. Oh, cool! Long Haul Paranormal Ice Road Ghost Truckers is on. Your favorite, right? What the fuck is that? Oh, hell yes. They have to make it over the Canadian tundra, weiß ich, wie man es ausspricht, before the ice road melts, but also they're hunting ghosts. Hmm. Also the trucks are haunted. This is an episode I've already seen, but it's one of the best. Callum and Flint Dogbone, the twin brother truck driving and ghost hunting duo, find themselves on their greatest peril yet. Oh no! The ghost done got control of the truck! I can't steer on them, they're damn ice roads! What's this, the Sven dialect? Let me use the EVP meter to try and communicate with the spirits. Flint, we're about to die! I almost got it! If you listen carefully, it sounds like it's saying, you're going to die! Hmm. That's because we're about to die, you! This is art. The episode ends and Amanda excuses herself to go and start arguments on the internet. Oh my god. I stay up a little longer, curious about the exploits of Callum and Flint Dogbone after their disastrous ice road accident. After what, I crawl into bed and get a good night's sleep. Beautiful, das ist doch schön. Wir haben jetzt hier einen Tagesabschluss und dann können wir hier mein Brötchen machen, ne? Machen aber direkt an dieser Stelle weiter. Oh, das ist interessant. Okay, wir machen hier noch keinen Cut. Wir gehen noch eben den Schlaf durch. Also, Schlafgeräusche. Morning, Sleepyhead. 5 more minutes. Okay, es ist doch schon der nächste Morgen. You have never ever let me have 5 more minutes. So, get up. Fine. Okay, aber hier ist echt ein guter Punkt jetzt. Ich meine, jetzt fängt doch wieder diese Goofy-Musik an. Okay, cool. Dann haben wir jetzt auch noch Damien kennengelernt. Ich weiß gar nicht. Und Hugo, ne? Mr. Vega. Ich weiß gar nicht, ob noch mehr kommen. Ich meine, es sind so viele Dads. Wie viele Routen hat dieses Spiel? Das ist krass. Ich weiß auch nicht, ob ich alle exploren werde oder könnte. Müsste ich gucken. Vielleicht brauche ich dann einen Guide. Aber das ist jetzt alles blind und deswegen finde ich es schon mal ganz interessant. Okay, dann geht's beim nächsten Mal genau an dieser Stelle weiter. Ich wünsche euch was. Ciao.